Hi everyone, my name is Jong-El Lee, and I'm representing the Team V-Beam at the Voice Privacy Challenge 2024. I would like to present our work entitled Voice Anonymization Using Emotion Enriched Feature Integration with STT and TTS Models. Speech data contain extensive personal information such as a speaker's identity, health, and social status, making them subject to privacy laws like the GDPR. Voice anonymization poses the challenge of generating speech that preserves linguistic and emotional content while protecting the speaker's privacy. Our proposed anonymization approach utilizes speech-to-text and text-to-speech models with three stages: feature extraction, feature integration, and speech synthesis. This idea originated from a simple concept: to try creating new audio using just the text and pitch information from the original speech. So here you see our voice anonymization pipeline. It uses original speech to recognize linguistic content in it with the STT model Whisper. Instead of using the bottleneck features and the speech recognition model, we use directly the text data. And we are extracting the fundamental frequency from original speech. To augment the emotional expressiveness of the anonymized speech, emotion class prototypes are calculated and integrated. Using these enriched F0 features and text embedding, we are synthesizing the audio to produce an anonymized speech. And this still contains the linguistic content, but doesn't have the original speaker information anymore. Let's go through the components one by one. So first of all, feature extraction. We have a speech recognition model, Whisper, the pre-trained STT model. This Whisper model is trained on English-only data and trained on a broad and diverse distribution of audio. We get the text data utilizing this STT model. And for extracting the fundamental frequency features, we use the Librosa library. After extracting F0 features, we calculated prototypes representing each emotion. We compile a pool of F0 features from the IMOCAP training data, which includes four emotion classes, as outlined in the voice privacy system. We then calculate prototypes for each emotion class by finding the centroid of standardized F0 features associated with each emotion. So we were able to obtain emotion prototypes representing the four emotions: neutral, sadness, anger, and happiness. And these are integrated with the F0 features using an attention-based mechanism. Because we get the text data, we convert the text into text embeddings using the symbol-based tokenization. Following the extraction and processing the features, the next stage integrates F0 features with text embedding using a feature-wise linear modulation layer, which is called film layer. The formula for the film layer is as follows. The scaling factor gamma is derived from the F0 features, where normalized layer standardizes the F0 features, and linear layer adjusts these features to the appropriate dimensions. The scaling factor is then applied to the text embedding feature map, which is TN here, using Hadamard product. We trained the film layer using the LibreSpeech Train Clean 360 dataset, and targeting to minimize the difference between the tests obtained from the original and synthesized audio samples using STT model. With this modulation, the film layer enhances the flexibility of the model. The final stage of our anonymization pipeline involves synthesizing the speech waveform from the integrated features. We utilize the VITS model for this purpose. We employed the pre-trained VITS model trained on the LG speech dataset, which consists of about 13,000 short audio clips of a single speaker. Consequently, the synthesized audio may reflect the voice characteristics of this single target speaker. Our experimental framework follows the Voice Privacy Challenge 2024 guidelines. There are three evaluation metrics considered for evaluation. The privacy of the anonymized dataset is assessed using an ASB system under a strong attacker scenario, where the attacker has access to several enrollment utterances per speaker and the voice anonymization system. Privacy protection is measured by the equal error rate. Utility is evaluated using two metrics, word error rate for ASR and unweighted average recall for SER. The first metric is the privacy metric assessed by using ASV attacker. That is actually pretty strong because it assumes that attacker knows our anonymization system. And because attacker is strong, the baseline models actually don't have a good performance. So they have pretty low equal error rate. And it means that it is easy for the attacker to distinguish whether an utterance came from a certain speaker or not. But our method produces anonymized data, which makes it difficult for the attacker. So we can see that we have the highest result with our method among the baselines. So we have an equal error rate that is about 45%. The second evaluation metric is the speech recognition metric, word error rate. Here, a lower score is better because we want to reduce the word error rate. As we move through the baseline from B1 to B6, the word error rate increases significantly for most models. When we focus on our model, we can observe that it performs better than most of the baselines. While our model does not achieve the best performance, it demonstrates better utility results than 3 out of the 6 baselines, showing a competitive level of utility compared to other approaches. The last evaluation metric for utility is the recall rate for speech emotion recognition. Here, a higher score is better. When we compare this to the baselines, others perform moderately well, but our model unfortunately shows the lowest performance in terms of emotion recognition. This clearly indicates that while our model may excel in other metrics, there is a significant gap in performance in terms of emotion recognition, especially compared to both the original data and some of the baselines. This highlights the need for further improvements and how our model handles emotional expressiveness. We will need to explore potential enhancements to improve the model's performance in this aspect. The figures compare the results of privacy and utility evaluation. In the first figure, our model in red achieves higher privacy indicated by the higher error rate, meaning stronger anonymization. However, this comes at the cost of lower utility with higher word error rate compared to some baselines, suggesting a trade-off between privacy and intelligibility. In the second figure, our model's recall rate is also lower than the baselines, reflecting a similar trade-off between privacy and emotion recognition accuracy. While the model provides strong privacy protection, it sacrifices some utility in the emotion recognition task. In conclusion, our model effectively anonymizes speech, but further improvements are necessary to enhance utility without compromising privacy. To summarize, our system is a voice anonymization pipeline that effectively combines text and fundamental frequency features. These features are integrated using a feature-wise linear modulation layer, and the final speech synthesis is performed by a pre-trained TTS model. In terms of privacy, our system shows exceptional performance, significantly outperforming the baselines and ensuring strong speaker anonymity. However, while utility is preserved in some areas, there is still room for improvement. Further optimization will be necessary to find a better balance between privacy and utility. Here are all my references. Thank you for listening to my presentation.